In the name of God, the most gracious, the most merciful, praise be to Allah, God Almighty, Lord and Cherisher of the world. And may God send His peace and blessings upon Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and those who rightly follow Him until the Day of Judgment. Amen. I had a big fight right now with Sheikh Farooq from Masjid al-Isra. Sheikh Farooq from Masjid al-Isra. This is how the fight started. I gave the Adhan 5 minutes before the calendar told me to give it. I gave the Adhan 5 minutes before the calendar told me to give it. And then he came, he grabbed the microphone away from me. And then after he did that, then what's it called? He shoved me. He grabbed me by my shoulder and shoved me. And then that's number two. Number two, he grabbed me by my shoulder and shoved me. Number three. Then he, what's it called? Said he's gonna call the police on me. And then he called a few of the Muslims. And then he said it's not everyone's masjid, it's his masjid. He said that. I kept telling him, say wahyat Allah, it's your masjid. When I started to tell him, say wahyat Allah, it's only your masjid, meaning it belongs exclusively to you. When I told him that, he didn't. Why not? It means he lied. To say it's exclusively yours, it's your masjid, it belongs to you and you only. To say you're the manager is one thing, but to say it's your property, it's your property, it belongs to you. Then I say wahyat Allah, it belongs to you. And he says, he doesn't say wahyat Allah. What does that mean? He lied. And then he grabbed me by my shoulder to shove me, and I didn't move. That's number two. Do you grab someone by his shoulder to shove him because he's doing an act of ibadah, and he has the delil to prove it's an act of ibadah? Do you grab someone and shove him because he's doing an act of ibadah? Number three. Do you need someone's permission to do an act of ibadah? That's number three. Number four. If it's an act of ibadah, who told me to do it? A sheikh or Allah? Who gives you the orders to do an act of ibadah? Allah. So who should you do it for? Allah. You should do it 100% for the sake of Allah and only for the sake of Allah, because it's an act of ibadah. That's number four. Number five. Ibn Taymiyyah, Sheikh al-Islam, Ibn Taymiyyah, rahmatullah alayhi, said, he said, ibadah is anything Allah loves internally, externally, of anything that He loves, anything Allah orders, anything Allah praises, anything Allah praises, orders. No, people who do it. So Allah says He loves those who are patient. That means patience, sabr, is an act of ibadah. Allah loves khushua, humility. So Allah, since Allah loves it, what does it mean? It means khushua, humility, is an act of worship. Allah loves knowledge. It means knowledge is an act of ibadah. Allah loves marriage. A man to get married, Allah loves it. It means marriage is an act of ibadah. So do you need anyone's permission to do an act of ibadah? The answer is no. Who ordered it? Allah. Who should you do it for? Allah. Anyone else? No. Do you need anyone's permission? No. If it's an act of ibadah, if it's someone's property, you need their permission to do an act of ibadah on their property. Why is that? I can't just say, hey Sheikh Farooq, whether you like it or not, I'm going to barge into your house and read Quran in your house. I can't do that in his house. Why not? Because that's his exclusive property. But if Masjid al-Isra is for all the Muslims, that means what? It means it's an act of ibadah. If Masjid al-Isra is for all Muslims, it means what? It means if it's for all Muslims, it means any ibadah you do in it, you don't need anyone's permission, including the Adhan. Why? Because it's a masjid, it's for all the Muslims. And you don't need anyone's permission to do an act of ibadah. And an act of ibadah is something that Allah Azza wa Jalla loves. Allah loves it. If Allah loves it, you gotta do it for His sake only. No, not 99%, not 95%, 100% for the sake of Allah. You have a store, and if your employee, you told your employee to do one thing, and the employee did it. He told your employee, do this and do that. Do this and do that. And do this and do that. Your employee did not do one thing. Your shagil, your worker, your employee failed to do one thing. I see it all the time. I see it all the time. The owner of that store goes furious. Why are you furious? Why are you yelling the living crap out of the employee? Why are you treating the employee like filth? Why are you talking to the employee like it's filth? What did the employee do? I told him to do one thing and he didn't do it. Or the employee did one thing without my permission. If the employee did one thing without your permission. If the employee did one thing without your permission. You treat him like a dog. You yell at him like a dog. You curse at him like a dog. If you told the employee to do one thing and he didn't do it, you also yell at him, curse him, treat him like filth. I'm asking you, what's greater, Allah's book or your store? Allah's book, Allah's laws or your store? Allah's laws or America? Allah's laws or the world? Allah's laws or the earth? What is greater? You say Allah's laws. You say Allah's laws is greater than the world. If Allah's laws is greater than the world, why is it that when Allah tells us to do something, if Allah loves something, if Allah praises something, if Allah orders us to do something, if Allah wants us to do something, internally or externally, He loves it, He praises it, He orders it, He praises the people who do it. When Allah does this to us, why, wait a minute, is this really a command in the Holy Quran? Is this really an authentic hadith? Tell me why I gotta follow this ayah. Tell me why I gotta follow this hadith. Why do I gotta follow this ayah? Why do I gotta follow this hadith? But what am I getting out of following this ayah? But what's the enjoyment out of following this hadith? You don't have to enjoy it. Just do it. Sami'na wa ata'na. Submission and surrender. Submission and surrender. Chapter 33, the Holy Quran. Allah's messengers, Allah says, chapter 33 of the Holy Quran, Allah says, it is not for a believer, man or woman, to have a say-so in the matter when Allah and His messenger give an order. If Allah told me to stand like a statue, I have to shut my mouth and stand like a statue. If Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if He told me to shut up and while I fly like a bird, I gotta fly like a bird. If Allah azza wa jal told me I gotta fly to Afghanistan and do jihad, if Allah showed me that in a dream, then I gotta do it. Whatever Allah shows me in a dream of righteous dreams, whatever Allah orders me to do, I gotta do it. Whatever Rasulullah alayhi wa sallam told me to do, I gotta do it. We have no say-so in the matter. If something is a bid'ah, we gotta break it. If something is haram, we gotta shun it. If something is a misguided, we gotta abstain from it. وَلَكُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ وَكُلُّ ضَلَالَةٍ بِالنَّارِ كُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ وَكُلُّ ضَلَالَةٍ بِالنَّارِ كل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة بالنار. Every bid'ah is a misguidance. Every bid'ah is an innovation. And every innovation is in the hellfire. The adhan. Where's the proof that the adhan clock is a bid'ah? Allah's messenger ordered the human being to give the adhan. So the adhan clock is an addition. It's something added to the religion, which makes it a bid'ah. Allah's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered the human being to give the adhan. So the adhan clock is a bid'ah. The adhan watch is a bid'ah. It is a bid'ah, which means it is an addition. A machine cannot do an act of ibadah. A machine cannot do an act of ibadah. And a machine cannot do an act of ibadah. To learn more about Islam, go to youtube.com and tap Ahmed Jibreel. youtube.com Ahmed Jibreel. Ahmed Jibreel.